angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Mild he lays his glory by, born that man no more may die, born to raise the sons of
Now the birth of Jesus Christ was as follows. After his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Spirit. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man, and not wanting to make her a public example, was minded to put her away secretly. But while he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take to you Mary your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. And she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. So all this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, Behold, the virgin shall be with child, and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which is translated, God with us. Then Joseph, being aroused from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord commanded him, and took to him his wife, and did not know her till she was brought forth her firstborn son. And he called his name Jesus.
Come, all is bright, rise. Let in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. Ooh. How silently, how silently the wondrous gift is given. So God imparts to human heart the blessings of his hand. No ear may hear his coming, but in this world of sin, where meek souls will receive him still, the dear Christ enters in. Ooh. O holy child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in, be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels, the great glad tidings tell. Oh, come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel.
And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Look down. we hear the carol Away in a Manger, it might well remind us of our childhood and the time where we sang it. And it reminds us of a story that's well known to most of us, and we may well have known it for many years. But it's still the greatest story that was ever told, because it tells us of how God sent his Son to earth for us. And what did we give him? We gave him a manger, a cattle trough for a bed. As we read the God-given account of the Nativity, it's a difficult story to read at times. Can you imagine what it must have been like for Mary, being so heavily pregnant and travelling probably by donkey that long and bumpy journey all the way to Bethlehem? It wasn't an accident that they returned to Bethlehem, because God in his scrolls through the prophet Micah had said that that was the place that Jesus would be born. But how difficult it was for them, after turning up at that place, to find out that every door would shut, no room would be found for the Lord Jesus Christ. Even though God had chosen Micah to announce the birthplace of the Lord Jesus, the town of Bethlehem was not ready that night for him. Very few people on earth were looking to God to send the Saviour of the world. Can you imagine for a moment what it must have been like for Mary and Joseph? They had travelled such a long way. Mary was about to give birth. They'd been on a dusty road. And now all they wanted was a place where they would be able to sleep. And they knocked door after door. Each one said, "Sorry, there is no room." And they rejected them. They had nowhere to go. At Christmas time, we traditionally think about a stable. But the Bible doesn't actually mention a stable, just a manger. So whether there was a stable or whether there wasn't, it's quite amazing, isn't it, that God gave the very best that he had. He gave the Lord Jesus to be born a Saviour. And all we gave him was a manger for a bed. For this wonderful night, Bethlehem wasn't ready. The world wasn't ready. But God was ready. For God was sending his Son to be called Emmanuel, God with us, who would become the Saviour of the world. God used Isaiah over 700 years before to show us this great sign that when the Virgin gave birth, then the Saviour would be here. An event as momentous as that was not going to be allowed to pass. So even though few were ready, God chose to announce it to poor humble shepherds, and he used thousands of angels to do that.
Born in Bethlehem.
No wonder the angels could sing, because the one that was born that day was the child that Isaiah had prophesied about. This one that was born was God, mighty God. He was also the one that could bring peace, the Prince of Peace. But so that he could bring us peace, this one who was perfect, this one that was truly God, must leave the manger, live a perfect life, showing exactly who he is, the perfect Son of God. And one day he would go to a cross, and there he would die, taking the punishment that you and I deserve. He loved us so much that he went to the cross for us.
The same country, shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Saviour, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." So it was, when the angels had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger.
If you were a shepherd at the time when Jesus was born in Bethlehem, well, you had one of the most lowly jobs that you could. In fact, shepherds were often seen as outcasts from society. And life was hard. Day after day, you would lead your sheep to water and green grass. so that the sheep would survive. You would be out on the hillside, in the blistering sun, and also in the cold nights. There you would be night after night, looking after the sheep, trying to keep warm. And every night and every day would be hard and look the same. Although I think the shepherds valued their routine and understood all the things that had to be done, they also looked for comfort in small things, and they looked for a distraction, something different to be able to do. One of the most interesting things must have been to have completed everything and be able to sit around the fire and just exchange stories. And you can imagine the hours of the night would roll away quicker if that was the case. For the shepherds that were there on that very first Christmas night, I'm sure that night started just like any other. They gathered up the sheep. They made a fire. They did all the things that they usually did as they were looking after the flocks by night. But the night changed. This would not be a night just like any other. Something amazing happened. Can you imagine their fear when all of a sudden before them an angel stood? And the angel told them not to be afraid. The angel had good tidings of great joy for everyone. As the angel spoke, I've got no idea how much the shepherds understood, but he told them in the city of David in Bethlehem, a Saviour who was Christ the Lord had been born. And as they tried to take this in, they were then told something strange. You will find the babe wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying in a manger, in a cattle trough. The shepherds must have been so confused. And yet, all of a sudden, there was this huge amount of angels, a heavenly host, praising God and saying glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. I'm sure the singing was absolutely beautiful, and the shepherds were totally distracted by it all. But then suddenly, the angels were gone away. For a few moments, I'm sure nobody said anything. Maybe nobody looked at one another. Maybe the shepherds just looked at the fire as the logs had burnt down during the time. And then they spoke. "Let's go to Bethlehem," said one. "Let's see what God wants us to know and who God wants us to meet." The shepherds made a decision that day. They decided to go to Bethlehem. They left their sheep and went down into the town. And the Bible tells us there they found Mary and Joseph. And just like the angels had said, the baby Jesus, the Saviour of the world, lying in a manger, a cattle trough. Those poor shepherds heard God's message. They heard what the angels had said. A Saviour was born. And they did as they said, and they went to Bethlehem and found the baby. There, they were privileged to be amongst the first to see the baby that was born to be the Saviour of the world. They were blessed. The Bible tells us that the shepherds returned to the hills, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they'd heard and seen. Imagine if one of the shepherds had found an excuse not to go. Maybe he didn't believe the angels. Or maybe he didn't even believe his eyes. Or maybe he didn't believe their message. Or he found some excuse not to go. Maybe he said, "I'll stay behind and watch the sheep while you go." That shepherd would have missed out on so much. Would have missed out on the blessings that God had for him. He wouldn't have returned to the hills glorifying and praising God for all the things he'd seen and heard. But sometimes we can be like that shepherd. Maybe we don't listen to God, and maybe we miss out on the blessings that God has for us. The greatest blessing that God has for us is in his Son, the Lord Jesus. You see, he told the shepherds through the angels that a Saviour, Christ the Lord, had been born. If we need a Saviour, it means that we need saving from something. What is that? Well, the angel told Joseph in that dream that Mary would bring forth a son, it would be the Son of God, and he would save his people from their sins. The Bible declares each and every one of us a sinner. And because of our sin, we face the punishment of sin. But this baby that was born came to be perfect, to show that he is the Son of God. And he came to go to a cross. Every step that he took in his life, through the miracles, through all the wonderful stories that he told, through his teaching, every step was perfect. And every step was going to a cross. This little baby, Emmanuel, God with us, came to this earth to die on a cross, to take your punishment and to take my punishment. And through putting our faith and trust in him, we can have our sins forgiven. The Bible promises this: believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, you will be saved. But just like the shepherds, we've got to do something about it. They heard the wonderful words of the angels, but they reacted to it. What will we do? Will we sit by the fire, listen to the wonderful story? Or will we declare to God that we're sinners? Will we put our faith and trust in the Lord Jesus Christ? Will we know the gift of God, eternal life, the greatest gift that we can have this Christmas? The carol that you've heard playing in the background says, "O come, all ye faithful." But none of us can truly claim that. And the Lord Jesus Christ came because we are sinners. And God invites you to come and receive pardon, love, and peace from him.
Unfaithful, come, weak and unstable, come, no, you are not alone. Oh, come, barren and waiting ones, weary of praying, come, see what your God has done. Christ is born, Christ is born, Christ is born for you. O come, bitter and broken, come, with fears unspoken, thank you. prince in royal David's city stood a lowly cattle shed where a mother laid her baby in a manger for his bed. Mary was that mother mild, Jesus Christ, her little child. He came down to and me.